Now we'll talk about a very important question, the relations of hyoglossus muscle. This in itself can be a short question in your theory papers in anatomy, and even it can be a question that can be asked in your viva in case you have got a case that is related to the tongue. So the relations of hyoglossus can be divided into two parts. One would be the superficial or the lateral relations, and the other would be the deep or the medial relations. Now, first we'll talk about the deep or the medial relations. These relations, this is something you may have to just mug up a little bit to remember. I have also drawn a picture down so as to show you how you can demonstrate that when you write your answers. It is very important that you also add diagrams to it, which makes it easier for your examiner to understand that you have an idea about the concept, and as well as it is easy for you to remember when you draw a diagram. So the deep or the medial relations are the inferior longitudinal muscle, which is close to the insertion, the middle constrictor of pharynx, and the second part of lingual artery, which is close to the origin, and the stylopharyngeus muscle, glossopharyngeal nerve, stylohyoid ligament, and the junction of first and second parts of lingual artery deep to the posterior border of the muscle. So these are the deep or medial relations. Next, we talk about the superficial or the lateral relations. This is what you will be depicting in the diagram. First of all, I've already mentioned how the hyoglossus is covered by the mylohyoid muscle. So if you remove the mylohyoid muscle, you will see certain structures which goes above downwards between these two muscles. Now, what are these structures that you can see from above downwards? So you have to remember the direction. It's from above downwards between these two muscles. These structures are the mucous membrane of the side of the tongue, the styloglossus muscle, the lingual nerve, the submandibular ganglion, which is suspended from the lingual nerve by two roots, the deep part of the submandibular gland and duct, the hypoglossal nerve, which is accompanied by a pair of veins, and the suprahyoid branch of the first part of lingual artery. I'll show you in the image over here. This is the right lateral view of the tongue. As you can see in the image, that this is the pink one that you see is the hyoglossus muscle. Now you'll see in the image that from above downwards, if you had to see, the first thing is the mucous membrane of the side of the tongue. Next comes the styloglossus muscle. Next comes the lingual nerve, the green structure that you can see. Next thing is the submandibular ganglion, and you can see that the submandibular ganglion is hanging from the lingual nerve by two roots. The next structure will be the deep part of the submandibular gland and the submandibular duct. Next structure is the hypoglossal nerve, which is the nerve supply for most of the muscles of the tongue, except for palatoglossus. And last part is the lingual artery. So you can see these are the lateral relations of the hyoglossus if you had to go from above downwards, which lies in between the hyoglossus and the mylohyoid muscle. So just copy this diagram and you can reproduce it in your papers, and it will be kind of easy for you to remember as well as you visualize it in front of your eyes.